Hey, what's up guys, Winston here, and today we'll be taking a quick look at the ASRock X570 Steel Legend motherboard. So as you know, earlier this year, ASRock unveiled their Steel Legend series of motherboards, featuring high build quality, great aesthetics, as well as steadfast stability. And that is true across the entire range of their Steel Legend motherboards, including, of course, this motherboard, the X570 Steel Legend. This motherboard features AMD's latest chipset, the X570, supporting all of the third generation AMD Ryzen processors. It also features the latest PCIe 4 standard and comes with an internal cooling fan on the chipset. You'll also find all of the usual ASRock features with this motherboard, including the M.2 slots for your SSDs, the steel PCI slot for your graphics card. There's also 10 power faces, 60 amp chokes, as well as Dr. Moss. And of course, don't forget the flexible IO shield for your back panel. It supports memory speeds of up to DDR4 4666 OC, as well as AMD Crossfire multi-GPU configuration, but no mention of SLI. With all these great features, this motherboard is perfect for any gamers as well as enthusiasts. We'll be putting the Ryzen 7 3700X into this motherboard and see how it performs. But before that, let's do a quick unboxing and we'll see you in a bit. All right, so here we have the ASRock X570 Steel Legend motherboard. Let's do a quick unboxing. It's the motherboard itself. And we'll take a look inside the box and see what's inside. All right, we have the quick installation guide, and there's a software setup guide. There are two M.2 screws, there's the drive disk, and two packs of the SATA cables, two in each. And there's the usual Steel Legend ASRock postcard. And that is pretty much it inside the box. Alright, now let's take a look at the motherboard itself. Alright, there we go. Here we have the ASRock X570 Steel Legend. It has a very nice black matte finish with a camo design, kind of grey and black, as well as white. Notice the large heat shield for your M.2 SSDs, and then there's an integrated fan for the chipset right here. There's also an M.2 Wi-Fi connector right there. So this motherboard comes in two versions, this one and also the same one with the built-in Wi-Fi 6. So I'm guessing this is where the Wi-Fi 6 chip will go there. All right, we have two PCIe slots right here, and this is of course the PCIe 4.0 standard. And you also have three additional PCIe one-time slot right there. Okay, here we have the DDR4 DIMM slots and supporting memory of up to DDR4 4666 OC. Okay, there's your AM4 socket supporting all the Ryzen third generation processors from AMD. There's a total of 8 SATA ports for your devices, storage devices. And there's the Podichrome pinout, RGB pinout right there. Okay. There's no start or reset buttons. You'll find that on the Phantom Gaming X. The motherboard requires the ATX pin for your power, 24 pin power, and also 8 pin as well as 4 pin. All right, let's have a look at the I/O shield. This motherboard comes with the flexible I/O that ASRock is featuring. And on the left, you'll see the HDMI port as well as display port. there's the usual USB 3 PS2 keyboard and mouse. There's the USB-C port there and USB 3.2 gigabit Ethernet LAN, and the Wi-Fi slot is missing, but this the antenna slots will go here for your Wi-Fi 6, and then usual array of audio connectors. Yeah, so this motherboard looks very nice, has a nice sleek design, and you'd be interested to see how this will perform where we put the Ryzen 7 3700X onto this motherboard. Alright, so without further ado, let's build a test rig and we'll see you in a bit. I'm not sure what ASRock has done to this motherboard, but all I can tell you is they've done a very good job with the X570 Steel Legend. As you know, I run all my tests in auto mode, and this usually means default BIOS settings both on the CPU speed and memory timings. But as it turns out in our tests, the memory ran natively at full speed of 3600 MHz with XMP profile enabled, while the Ryzen 7 3700X automatically ran at a boost speed of 4.2 GHz. The default speed is 3.6 GHz. With these auto-enhanced settings, we got some great scores in all of our benchmarks, including an impressive Cinebench score of 2,074 and a PC Mark 10 score of 6,868. For Port Royal, we got a high score of 6,461 with a DLSS score of 43.26 frames per second. For 3D Mark, TimeSpy and Firestrike, we got a score of 10,907 and 23,183 respectively. As far as design and build quality is concerned, ASRock continues its Steel Legend philosophy with its high build quality, steadfast stability and great aesthetics. I really love the camera design and polychrome RGB lighting effects. The X570 Steel Legend also comes with a lot of features that I didn't expect for a mainstream motherboard, such as the 10 power phase design, the M.2 Armor full cover heat shield, the support for DDR4 4666 OC, the AMD Crossfire multi-GPU support, as well as the Thunderbolt 3. You can get the ASRock X570 Steel Legend from various retailers, including Amazon, for about $199. At this price, it's probably one of the best value X570 motherboards you can get right now. The ASRock X570 Steel Legend motherboard is a great buy if you're planning to upgrade or switch over to the Ryzen 3000 processors. It comes with plenty of features and offers good performance at a price that's extremely attractive. You can check out a full review on our website at thinkgeek.com. And there you have it. This is the ASRock X570 Steel Legend motherboard, offering high build quality, steadfast stability, as well as great aesthetics with performance to match, and is suitable for all of the third generation AMD Ryzen processors. Hope you enjoyed this video. Give us a like and leave a comment down below. Don't forget, you can actually buy this via the links in the description. And of course, subscribe to our YouTube channel and visit our website for more news, reviews, and hot tips. Until next time, this is Winston for ThinkGeek.com.